Good afternoon and welcome to today's Duo Tasty. I'm going out on a limb a bit here, off the beaten track. This is a tiny bit exotic. We've got Albastril Blanc de Carbonet from Moldova 2021 and Tesco's answer to Matthias or Wolfgang Amadeus. And that's 10%. Wine to be enjoyed at sunset with friends. Oh dear, no sunset. No friends. Never mind, got a pineapple. And the Albastril, 13%. Moldova has produced quality wines for over 2,000 years, bottles of which have notably graced the tables of the Russian Tsars. Today, its distinctive Black Sea climate and hilly landscape continue to produce wines of increasingly high quality. Lots of awards, white wine made from gently pressed red Cabernet Sauvignon, pale gold, green hints, passion fruit, peach and apricot. Well, let's see if we can do that. So a bit later on today, I'm going to make a chicken wok. And I thought, to be fair, we've still got a bit of summery sunshine. So I really felt these two would be a fantastic match for the food, but a contrast with one another. So let's try Albastril. Oops, Blanc de Carbonet. And because it's ever so slightly effervescent, I thought I'd put this in here for once. There we go. Beautiful. Don't mind if I do. Pretty in pink. Port du Sol. Right, let's try this Albastril. So we've got fantastic pineapple looks here. Oh, beautiful fruit nose. It's all fruit, honestly. Yeah. Can see that peach, apricot, passion fruit, pineapple, lychee. Not hugely exotic, but definitely all those soft summer fruits. Quite a lot of banana, actually. Tiny bit of kiwi fruit. Bit of greengage. As a superbly rounded wine. I mean, you expect something a bit more at 13% with a white wine. That is a fantastic dinner wine. That is going to go so well with chicken. Absolute perfect match. And it's like drinking molten gold. Fantastic. Really, really lovely. The tiny, tiny hint of buttercream notes with, you know, a little bit of salted caramel. Some strawberry mousse and a bit of baked camembert, I think. It's not really a mineral wine. It's definitely dry, but so much fruit depth and a nice long finish as well. I have to say that's one of the most impressive white wines I have opened this year. And I think it retails for around about £12 to £13 on Laithwaite's, but you do get a discount if you purchase 12, so it's well worth looking into it. I highly, highly recommend the Albastril label from Moldova, but this Blanc de Carbonet, and of course, if you can get one from anyone else, you know, France to this grape. It's one of these fantastic wines that has been made white from a red grape, and the extra time and care taken on these wines is, you know, it's immeasurable. It's very much like the Sofia I had earlier in the year, which was from Sangiovese. And now here's a nice bit of pink for you. I just love this. It's great. Perfect glass. Look at that. All strawberry and rose petals on the nose. This is a much forgotten and underrated wine, but it's fantastically refreshing, and in fact, absolutely ideal when you've got a heavier white wine such as this one. You know, you'd be hard pushed to find a comparative white wine that would pair with this brilliantly and not either overshadow it or, you know, just be completely displaced. So I think the total contrast here has been a stroke of genius, if I may say so. Do you know what? That is absolutely gorgeous. I highly recommend that. That was Tesco's and it was £4.75. It's just really, really nice to look in on these sort of almost old-fashioned wines, which you may have drunk years ago, and now you've, you know, moved on a bit in the wine world and all that. But when you go back to them, you'll find a whole new depth of expression in them because your palate has developed so much more. You know, at one time I would have just thought, oh, this is a cheap pink, and it's almost red, in fact, but now I can really taste a lot going on in the glass, and it's not because there is necessarily a lot going on in the glass, but just because my, it's like when you do music and you listen to orchestral music and you try to pick out the violas from the violins, you know, it's a very, very difficult task, and over time it improves your hearing so unbelievably. And this is the same thing with music and wine. You know, wine is a symphony in a glass. Admittedly, most wines are chamber orchestras rather than full-blown symphony orchestras, but there's definitely a bit of cymbal and a triangle in that one.